Well, this week we are celebrating all things Neighbours, and it's been more than 27 years since Jarrod Vincenzo, Toadfish, Rebecchi arrived on Ramsay Street.
Yeah, and since then we've seen him cause a ruckus in high school to become a lawyer and marry the love of his life, only for this to happen.
I do. From this day, may you go forward in peace as husband and wife. Friends and family, may I present Mr. and Mrs. Jarrod Rebecchi.
I can't believe it. The Maldives.
A week of whatever your heart desires. You get the most beautiful smile.
I love you.
Kiss me, wife.
Oh, it's heartbreaking. Yeah, and Ryan Moloney joins us now live from Melbourne. Ryan, Toadie was meant to start in one scene, 27 years later, and he's still on Ramsay Street. How did you land that role?
I auditioned for a character called Brett Stark, but apparently I wasn't nerdy enough. And then there was another character called Stonefish who I looked pretty similar. So it was really just the hairstyle that actually got me the gig. They rang up and they said, is your hair still the same? I was like, yes, it is. So they went, okay, we've got a role for you.
Toadie, can we take a moment to talk about that glorious mop of yours, that iconic mullet? Were you sad to see it go eventually? Talk us through it.
No, I was not sad to see that thing go. That looked like I had a dead rat hanging off the back of my head. I have no idea how it is now fashionable. I'm looking at all these kids now, I'm just like, oh my God, you're just trying to look ugly. I don't know.
Oh, we're looking at a photo of you.
I love it.
1995, this must be the first press photos you did. You were so little, so young, wow.
Oh, it's great. Toadie.
Oh, mate, they made me keep that thing for years.
Well, rightly so, though.
Wasn't it like a stunt mullet you could have like brought on set or something like that?
I think I finally got my first girlfriend once it was cut off. Before then, no chance.
Come here, Toadie and Dee's short-lived marital bliss caused controversy around the world. Did Toadie ever expect for Dee to come back?
No, Toadie didn't. I don't think anyone expected Dee to come back. But you know what? This is a soap, and you know, if Harold can do it, what then the... so can Dee.
I was like saying that. I never expected Harold to come back.
Yeah, that's right. I never expected to marry Harold either, but, you know, anyway, that's a different story.
Toadie then fell in love with and married Sonia, but then she tragically died from cancer. What's going on with Toads? Is he the luckiest and unluckiest bloke of all time when it comes to love? Or is that Dr. Carl?
Yeah, I think Toadie's definitely the kiss of death. I think, I don't know, you know, I think Toadie's done all right. I think he's definitely punching above his weight. But, I think, yeah, it's almost nearly a death sentence for anyone that ends up with him.
Oh.
I love your character. I always have. Growing up in Ireland, watching it as well, I used to always remember coming home from school and seeing it. You were a teenager when you started on the show. What was that like, growing up in front of the whole world, not just here in Australia?
It's a strange question to answer, really, because I don't know any different. Mm. It's been one hell of a ride, really. I mean, I've had some pretty crazy experiences just because, you know, I've been on TV and, you know, been able to work overseas. And just some of the experiences I've had have just been amazing. So I've been incredibly, incredibly lucky.
Yeah, well, you know, you're also brilliant at what you do. You've got incredible fans around the world, celebrities like Chris Martin from Coldplay. This bloke standing next to me has been banging on about you coming on the show for days and days. He's like your biggest fan in the world. He adores you.
Just put me on the spot there.
No offense, not to make it awkward or anything. Does that kind of blow you away?
I don't know. You know, it's just it's one of those things. You know, I don't really kind of take it all too seriously. You know, if somebody thinks, you know, you're fantastic, then that's awesome. At the end of the day, I just try to I turn up and I do a really good job. I say the words and then I go home, and then you know, my wife tells me to do the dishes, so you know, it's no different.
Well, I think because at the time growing up, I mean, you were a teenager doing the show. I was a teenager on the complete opposite side of the world.
Yeah.
You know, but we kind of could still relate in that kind of way. I just loved your character. I thought it was superb.
Did you grow a mullet?
No, they didn't really kick off in Ireland, to be honest with you. But I'm going to do it now. I'm going to do it now.
And any mullet growing tips for him, Ryan?
Yeah, just don't.
Just don't. What are some of your most memorable memories from Neighbours? You know, what some of your favourite moments when you look back on?
Probably we did the full Monty episode. That was that was pretty good. That was a pretty good time. And then all the wrestling stuff. So Toadie was mad into wrestling. And then there's a House of Trouser. Basically, there was like two lots of House of Trouser where it was basically, you know, three of us just seeing what we could get away with on television, and we just tried to do the stupidest stuff. And then, you know, we had good directors that would just go, yeah, okay, we'll do that. So then they started writing for it, and it was just out of control. It was so good. But I think probably the best storyline, I think, was probably Sonia's death. Being that we actually went away for an entire week, and Eve and I have such a close relationship that it was actually really kind of nice to do something so big and so amazing and so in-depth, and to have, I think it's the first time ever that we've had an episode where it's just a two-hander. So, you know, I think that kind of, you know, speaks for itself. I think that's probably the best storyline that we've done.
Yeah, wow. Well, there's a reason why fans around the world are rallying around Neighbours. It's a brilliant show. You've made this guy's day. Thank you so much, Ryan. Neighbours airs Monday to Thursday nights at 6:30 on 10 Peach. Thanks for joining us, Toadie.
No worries, guys. Thanks for watching.
Bye.
Take care.